Hello everyone. Today I'll be discussing about total internal reflection. Okay, we can call it as a TIR in short form. Okay, let us consider the surface or the interface between the two medium. Okay, this is the air medium and this is the water medium. Just imagine like that. So this is the rarer medium and this is the denser medium, where the speed of light is less and here the speed of light is more. And here we can keep on source. I'll call it as a S. S is the source which is kept in the denser medium. Okay, now light will travel via normal. Okay, here is the normal. Normal is the imaginary perpendicular line which is drawn on the surface. To understand incident light ray, refracted light ray or reflected light ray. Okay, when the light ray travels via normal, it will go undeviated. Okay, so where I can say that angle of incidence will be equal to angle of refraction, that will be equal to zero in the first case. And now I'll call it as a source S here, and this is the incident light ray SB and AB is the refracted light ray. Very simple. In the second case, now what I will do, I'll bend the incident light ray and it will come and hit the normal at an angle I, that will call it as the angle of incidence. And now light travels from denser media to rarer media, it will go away from the normal. I'll call it as a R. R is angle of refraction. Okay, now I'll call it as a SD is the incident light ray, DE is the refracted light ray. Okay, this is the second case. And when light travels from denser media to rarer medium, the refracted light ray will move away from the normal. Okay, I mean there is a change in the path of the light because there is a change in the speed of the light. Okay, in the next case what will happen, now the light ray will come and hit the normal. Okay, it is certain angle, I'll call it as a I. Okay, for this case the refracted ray will make 90 degree with the normal. This is a refracted light ray. You can see here the changes. Here the light traveled via normal without any deviation, here slightly bended. When you increase the incident light ray furthermore, okay, then the refracted light ray will make 90 degree with the normal. Okay, when it becomes 90 degree with the normal, then I'll call it as a, I mean incident angle as a critical angle C. Okay, in the fourth case what I will do, okay, in the fourth case what I will do, I'll increase the angle of incidence furthermore, okay, above the critical angle. Now the light ray will come back to the same medium. Okay, I'll call it as a SF and FI is the refracted light ray here. Okay, this is SN is the incident light ray here. And this is the NO is the reflected light ray. This is called angle of incidence here. And this is called angle of reflection. Clear? And here we have discussed about critical angle. Clear? Important thing. What is critical angle? When the light ray travels from denser media to rarer media, at certain angle of incidence I, the refracted light ray will make 90 degree with the normal, then the angle of incidence we will call it as a critical angle. Okay, in the next, if you furthermore increase the angle of incidence, what will happen? The light will come back or bounce back to the same medium. So we will call it as a total internal reflection. Okay, this is the important thing we have to remember about the total internal reflection. Okay, next one, what are the two conditions for total internal reflection? Okay, okay, first case, what will happen? The light must travel from okay, the light must travel from denser medium to rarer medium. Okay, in the second case, the angle of incidence must be greater than critical angle. Then only we can achieve TIR. This is an important point you have to remember here. Okay, so basically, what is total internal reflection? When the light travels from denser medium to rarer medium, at the interface between the two mediums, at certain angle of incidence, the light will comes back to the same medium from where the light originated. This overall procedure is called total internal reflection. And must be remembered one point here, the angle of incidence must be greater than critical angle. Okay, so and we have discussed here what is critical angle. So when the angle of incidence at certain point, the refracted light ray will make 90 degree with the normal and it is sleeping or grazing on the surface. This is the important point we have to remember here. Then it will become a critical angle here, remember, and this angle is less than critical angle. Okay, this angle is greater than the critical angle. Okay, this is all about the total internal reflection we have to remember. Okay, thank you for watching the video and please subscribe for this video.